You want to leave? You just got here.
Carly, you hired Holden to break horses. Now, there is nothing for him to do out here except hang out with Molly.
And that's exactly what you want to prevent. Right. Just listen to me for a second, okay? Sometimes horses go.
Yeah.
Horses come back sometimes. We're gonna find them.
We've looked. Time's a waste.
No. They're gonna show up. Probably sooner than you think.
What makes you so sure about that?
I know horses.
And like I said, no horses. Holden and I are out of here. Now, if you'll excuse me, I left something in the trunk.
Guess I better head out.
Holden? You know, last night when I was hurting really bad, I just kept thinking about Abigail. When she won those jelly beans at the fair. You know, when she smiled, she looked exactly like you.
You know, she kind of reminded me of Mama.
You're right. She did. When she smiled, she had that look that Emma does when she's really pleased about something.
Holden, could you help me out? I have a loose floorboard in my bathroom, and I think I'm going to break my neck unless it gets fixed.
Couldn't you ask Jack?
Well, Jack isn't in the mood to help anybody right now.
Yeah, sure. Sure, I'll take a look at it.
What are you doing? You were supposed to be helping me with Holden, not messing things up.
I am helping you.
Then why did you make Holden go look at your floorboards? We just started talking.
I don't care if he was about to declare his undying love. We have a problem here. Jack just told me if we don't come up with the horses soon, he and Holden are leaving.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. Now, I don't know exactly what soon means, but I figure we don't have a lot of time. We have to come up with a good lie. And fast.
I got a better idea. Let's tell the truth.
Yeah, Mikey. Yeah, I need you to do a job for me. See what you can come up with on a Carly Tenney. T-E-N-N-E-Y. Yeah, that's it. I want it.
Told Holden the truth 13 years ago. We might have stayed together.
We'll never know, will we?
Well, my life would have been so different if we had.
Will you forget ancient history and concentrate on now?
I am not just thinking about the past here. Look, when Holden and I left Smithfield, we spent the night together.
I'm really happy for you about that.
I know, but it wouldn't have happened if I wasn't honest with him. For the first time since I came back and saw him, I was honest. I told him exactly how I felt, that I never stopped loving him.
Molly, please, would you save that for your memoirs? We have a crisis on our hands here.
This is important. I don't think we would have made love if I hadn't told him the truth. I know that it was only for one night, but I was the happiest that I've ever been, and that is why I think we need to be honest with him right now.
Okay. Well, there's honest, and there's honest. Telling Holden you love him, that's one thing. Telling him you scammed him into coming out here, that's something else entirely, you understand?
Why do you care so much about this?
Because we're family. And you're really growing on me.
I still think we don't have a choice but telling the truth. I mean, we don't have any horses, and it doesn't look like we're gonna.
Yeah, maybe. But I think I may have a plan.
Is it like your last one? Because if it is...
Okay, now, I'm not making any guarantees here, but I think this is going to work. Look, Molly, if you want to hang on to Holden, this may be your best shot. Besides, what I'm planning is as close to the truth as we're going to get.
Is your arm all right? You okay?
Fine. At least I will be... when I clear these things up.
What things?
I have to tell you something, Holden. I should have done it before, but...
Oh! You gotta come quick, man. You're not gonna believe it. What, you think this is funny?
No, I think you're funny. What is it with you people who work for the government? You see conspiracies everywhere.
Hey, Carly, don't try to turn this into something about me. You and Molly...
But Molly and I aren't scamming anybody, Jack. We never plotted anything. We never conspired together. Hey, I hardly know her. I only just met her when she came out here with you and Holden, remember? So why don't you just chill out a little?
So if you never met her until we showed, how do you know about what a tough life she's had?
Because she told me. Jack, what is with you? The girl wears her heart on her sleeve 24 hours a day, or hadn't you noticed?
Sure, but... Wait a minute, she told you about her life.
Hey, it's a woman thing. We share more easily than guys. It's no big deal.
Right.
Yeah. Look, I think Molly's a great girl. And you gotta feel sorry for her, but I never did anything for her. I asked Tolan to come out here to break these horses because I heard he was one of the best. That's it. Now, will you stop making me the star of your latest conspiracy theory?
Yeah. Sorry. Sometimes I go off the deep end.
Yeah. Well, just make sure there's enough water next time, okay?
Hey! It's good you guys both are here because Holden and I have come up with a great idea.
Yeah, we figured we'd all go out somewhere tonight.
Oh, that sounds great.
Yeah, do dinner out and then go have some fun.
Yeah, it's called Scrappies. They have good food, good music, good beer.
Then that's it.
Wait a minute. I thought we hired Molly as the cook, so why do we have to eat out?
Since when did you become slave driver Jack?
Come on, Jack. We've all been chasing horses, worrying about them. I've been out there trying to break them all
day
long.
Which is exactly why we should stay home, right? Have Molly cook us up something interesting and just kick back, relax.
You know, I can make up a lot of fantasies about you, Jack, but being dull isn't one of them. All work and no play. You know what that makes you, don't you?
I am just thinking about Molly's welfare. The doc told her she had to stay off her feet.
No, he didn't. He told me that I needed to get lots of rest. And I hardly think that going out to dinner is going to wear me down, Jack.
You know, Molly, one minute, you're too weak to travel, and the next minute, you want us all to go out to dinner.
Hey, Jack, come on, lighten up, you know? If you don't want to go out, you don't have to. I'll take the girls. But you don't have to give them a hard time.
I'm not.
Well, then what do you say, Jack? Home alone or Forrest company?
No, I'll go.
All right, then let's do it. I knew this party animal would come alive.
This place is just so...
Western.
Yeah, you gotta love it.
I do.
Who's up for a game of darts, huh?
No darts. I love this song. We have to dance.
Oh, yeah, come on.
Molly, I'm not good at this kind of stuff.
I am sure you can. Come on, G-Man, you owe me one.
I do. Why?
Because I said so, that's why.
Come on, hold me.
Molly, I'm really terrible at it, I'm telling you.
So we'll be terrible together. Come on.
Terrific.
Well, I'm not done dancing yet. Come on, Holden.
At a table.
Come on, you should be really getting some rest, remember?
I'm fine.
That's not what you said when the doctor was there. Obviously, you're a fast healer.
Not at everything.
That diamond burning.
So, you know, it's kind of interesting the way you and Carly hit it off.
Thinking now. What do you mean, Jack?
You know, the way you've gotten so close after only a day or so. Like you two are old friends.
Sometimes that can happen. You just meet somebody and you hit it off.
Sure. Carly said you told her a lot about your past.
So?
No, I just think it's odd. You opening up to someone who's supposedly a stranger.
Why are you always so suspicious of me?